So the November 2020 question 5C. Let's go 5B, right? So 5A is about mergers and acquisition. Process of failed mergers and acquisition, we'll talk about them. Now question 5B. Zentex Limited is an unlevered firm. So this company has no debt, right? The firm expects to generate operating profit, that is EBIT, of 20 million each year in perpetuity. So EBIT is 20 million. The firm's current market value is 80 million and pays tax at the rate of 30%. So you have corporation tax, Ipapo. The management of the firm is considering the use of debt financing. The firm's financial analysts have estimated that the present value of any future financial distress cost is 8 million and that the probability of financial distress would increase with leverage according to the following schedule. Value of debt equal 2.5, probability 0.00. Pre-tax cost of debt, we have it there. The firm's ungeared asset beta is 0.6. So the beta is 0.6. The risk-free rate of return is 8%. The expected return on the market portfolio is 15%. The cost of equity of a levered firm shall be captured using CAPM. The cost of equity of a levered firm shall be captured using CAPM. The Hamada model shall be applied to capture the levered equity beta. Okay. Then for 2 months, they want us to get the current cost of equity and the WACC. That one you can do, right? Current cost of equity is the RF plus RM minus RF. That's the beta. But again, by the way, we can get the cost of equity using EBIT. We are just for tax to divide by 8. Delivered farm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the best way to be very sure and to be very safe, we have EBIT.
Yes.
We have the tax.
Yes.
And we have the value of the farm.
Yes.
And this farm is unlevered. Mm-hmm. So you're better off doing EBIT, you adjust for tax, you divide by 8 to get the cost of equity. Because what it will be is the cost of equity of a levered farm. Okay. But unlevered firm, we can get it. Anyway, there's something that I want us to say first of all. The Hamada model. Hamada model, Mr. Mahal. Mr. Leo. We've not done special topics, right? So can we talk about special topics and we start with Hamada model so that it can help us even answer this question. So special topics in financing. So special topics in financing, let's start with Hamada model. Hamada model, sometimes it's called geared end and geared beta. Geared end and geared beta. Geared end and geared beta. So we say this. The beta factor is a measure. The beta factor is the measure of systematic risk. The beta factor is a measure of systematic risk. Stop. The beta of unlevered firm. into brackets, asset beta, stroke, unlevered stroke, and gear beta. That is BA. BA for asset beta. Is only affected by systematic risk. Is only affected by systematic risk. When levered beta, stroke equity beta, stroke geared beta, that is BE. Is affected by both systematic and gearing stroke leverage risk. Is affected by both systematic stroke gearing stroke leverage stroke financial risk. So equity beta, that is the beta of a levered firm, is affected by both the systematic risk, and it's also affected by the gearing or the financial risk. So what we mean is that BA is on a systematic risk for gearing. Because how would BA in a debt? The debt is for the unlevered firm, the firm that has no debt. But when you talk about the BE, is affected by both systematic risk, and it's also affected by what? The financial stroke gearing risk. The risk of using debt. That's all. Then you can just say opportunity. For this reason, BA is always lower than BA is always lower than BE. For this reason, BA is always lower than BE. So asset beta inakuanga kidogo kwa equity beta. Kwa sababu gani? Asset beta iko na risk moja peke yake. Equity beta iko na risk mbili. The systematic risk and the financial risk. Continue by saying this. The asset beta, in brackets BA, of firms in the same industry, the asset beta of firms in the same industry is always equal. The asset beta of firms in the same industry is always equal. We'll stop. Next question, Mike. We can determine the equity beta. We can determine the equity beta of the asset beta. We can determine the equity beta or the asset beta using Hamada model, depending on circumstances. Using Hamada model depending on circumstances. BE equals, so the equity beta equals BA, asset beta times we take the value of equity, we add. So value of equity, we add the after-tax value of debt, we divide by value of equity. So VE plus the after-tax VD divided by VE. I'm just trying to adopt a more direct formula. Kuna formulas zingine, but this one I feel it's more direct because now, kama umepewa VA, unatafuta VE. Utakuwa umepewa the values of debt and equity. You can apply the values. What if I want VA? Can I make VA the subject? VA would be equals to VE. Times what? E and the juice, no. I love being up your chin. Right? Yeah. So that if I want the PA, I'll take the PE. I multiply by what? PE divided by PE plus what? PD adjusted for tax. The only thing I want us to know is that when you're looking for BE and you have BA, your answer should be higher than the BA. Sababu tumesema, BA is always lower than BE. So, ukiangalia hapa kama niko na BA, kama hapa itakuwa kubwa. See, my answer will be higher than this. So, if I'm looking for BE, na napata labda BA ilikuwa 1.2, the BE, the equity beta should be greater than 1.2. Because equity beta is always greater than asset beta. And next time, if the examiner has not given you the values, has given you the weights, you can also use the weights. So I can get the PE by taking the PA times the weight of equity plus the weight of debt adjusted for tax divided by weight of equity. So you can either use the weights or the values, depending on the metro information gain. That's all. And why are we doing all this? We are doing all this because we know WSCC equals to Weke plus what? WDKD. We adjust for tax. Ili tupate KE, tunatumia KPM. Na kwa KPM ama nini? SML or CML? SML, ndio. KPM or SML, which equals to RF plus RM minus RF times the beta, ndio. Sasa hapa kwa beta, let me put it here. So RF plus RM minus RF. Hapa kwa beta. Joseph na Juliza, which beta are you going to use? If the firm has no debt, I'll use the bar. If the firm has no debt, I'll use the bar. See, asset beta is the beta for unlevered firm. But if the firm has debt, I have to use what? Okay. So if I'm doing the KE of a levered firm, then I must ensure that I'm using the asset, the equity beta. If the firm has debt, I must ensure that I'm using the equity beta. But if a firm has no debt, then I must ensure that ile beta natumia ni gani. Sasa kwa inasumbua na from the examiner anapenda hii concept sana. Nenda kuiona sisi siko kwa 2020. The 2020 aliweka ndani ya MM4. So MM4 akaweka portfolio ndani, akaweka special topic ndani. And it was joy doing it kwa mwenye anajua. Mwenye ajui anatafuta marks kingine hizo unaachana na. Anyway, mind the feet. AE is RF plus RM minus RF times the beta. So we need to ask ourselves, are we using the equity better or are we using the asset better? We shall always use the asset better if the firm has no debt. So it shall be guided accordingly. And for 2020, when it will be a KE of the delivered firm, that will be a year. That is how they guided us. Sasa, hivyo adivyo examiner alisema ufanye hivyo. But under normal circumstances, sasa hapa haina keu na keu. Hapa kwa special topic sasa. CNF2. Sasa, CNF2. Special topics. Right together. Good. So let's go to that 2020. Transit idea. So, we go through it together again. Celltex Limited is an unlivered firm. November 2020, question 4B, 5B. Question 5B. So, Celltex is an unlivered firm. The firm expects to generate operating profit, that is EBIT of 20 million each year to perpetuity. The firm's current market value is 80 million. See any value of equity? It's an unlivered firm and pays tax at the rate of 30%. When you see the tax rate, we start thinking about MM2 going forward. Yeah. MM2 going forward. The management of the firm is considering the use of debt financing. The firm's financial analysts have estimated that the present value of any future financial distress costs is 8 million and that the probability of financial distress would increase with leverage according to the following schedule. So value of debt equal 2.5 million, probability of financial distress to Konayo to Kona pre-tax cost of debt. Pre-sini before tax. Uh-huh. The firm's ungeared asset beta is 0.6. So tumepewa ba. Na ukumbuke, kama umepewa ba, na kuna debt, lazima utafute pe. Hizo siri ndogo ndogo lazima tuzijue. Kama umepewa ba, and there is debt involved, you must get what? Pay. So that now you can use the pay on your capel to get the AE. So you can use the pay to get the KE. RF is 8%. Expected return of the market portfolio is 15%. The cost of equity of a levered firm shall be captured using capel. The Hamada model shall be applied to capture the lever or equity beta. So that's what you're saying. Doesn't matter to apply the Hamada model. The current cost of equity and WSCC. So KE. Equals to what? EBIT. We adjust for tax. We divide by what? The value of equity. Somebody it will be after to me to compare for cost of equity of the levered. And levered on a formula that applies. Leo. EBIT happy.
Okay.
EBIT ni 20 million. Leo. Can't switch my query happy. So 1 minus 0.3. What is the value of the firm? 80. So cost of equity of unlevered firm? 17.5%. So that gives us the 2 marks. And the WSCC. How do you get the work of unlevered firm?
Okay.
Namambia kwa work of unlevered equals what? Ambayo ni 17.5%. The 2 marks have been confirmed. We start looking for 48. Passing ni kujipanga. Ukishapata pass ndio utafuta watu. Wewe ndio utafuta watu before pass. Pass ndio ya kwanza, award baadaye. Kwanza tukizungumzia award hiyo kupiga kwenye kile kunevuka. Hapo niambia watu waachie watu. Commitments zetu zinashinda hawa. Mimi nimesema. Now the first optimal level of debt whether it tulipata award ya tax. Advanced tax report an award. Which is very clear. Na mwenye alipata award alikuwa mtu wa evening. Kwa hiyo si mtu wa evening. Alikuwa mtu wa evening. Alikuwa anafunzwa na wafuna. But anyway, the funds optimal, I also teach tax by the way, not only FL. I also teach tax, some tax. Now the funds optimal level of debt using pure MM with corporation tax model. The optimal level of debt is that one MM2. So using MM2. So we can talk about the value of debt so that we can have the value of the levered firm. Value of the levered firm under MM2 equals to value of undeterred plus what? BD times what? Times tax rate. So, debt equal to 2.5. Value of unlevered income? Is it 80? Plus the debt of 2.5 times ngapi? Times 0.3. What is the value? 80? 80.7. 80.75. 80.75. Debt next ngapi? 5.0. So debt equal 5.0. The value of unlevered firm is 80 plus 5.0 times 0.3. See this one I am sitting again. If I turn the 7 I didn't give this here. This one is 81.5. 81.50. So by the way, optimal debt level is the debt level that you know for the highest value still. So you don't have to the highest value up and we have to come and near optimal debt level is 5 million. So you have killer level. How much is the debt that gives us the highest value? From the by the look of the information, it's about 20 million. 20 million, yes. So the optimal debt level is finished. 20 million. Make sure you write it. Make sure you write it. Even if you don't write it now, you write it in the example. Alright, let's go to part three. Let's get the 8 marks. Let's get the 8 marks. In fact, we are being told the pound's optimal WOCC and hence its optimal capital structure. The firm's optimal WACC and hence its optimal capital structure proportions. Wametuambia kuwa KE of the levered firm tutaitumia kutoka tutaicalculate kutumia capel. Yeah. So I have to go one step at a time. You have to go one step at a time. So you can bring in the concept of MM4. And bring in the concept of MM4 so that we say we have the value of debt, the value of the firm. We need to get the value of the levered firm. Or let's have the value of debt. We shall look for the value of equity. I'm going to itafuta pole pole. They need to get the value of the levered firm. And the value of the levered firm equals what? value of unlevered plus VD times tax minus what? Present value of interest, present value of financial distress costs. So that out of this value, I can get the value of equity. After I have the value of equity, can I get the BEP? BEP equals what? BAT times VE plus what? VD adjusted for tax, right? We divide by what? We divide by VE. Nikisha pata BE. Sasa nitaweza kupata KE. And kisha pata KE, sasa naweza pata wakaka. Naweza pata wakaka. Sasa sijui kama kuna space ya kutosha, niongeze huko columns mbili. Must enter next page. So that now here, I need to get the KE. The KE wamesema is RF plus what? RM minus RF times what? Bar or pay? Times pay. Then finally, it after nini? Which is YK plus what? Adjust for tax. Section 5, yeah. Big in section 5. It's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. Hi. Debt ya kwanza ni 2.5. Debt ikwa 2.5. Value of the family gap. Value of the firm. Value of unlevered. Is it 80? Plus 2.5 times 0.3. Minus, we have the present value of financial distress costs. They were on 8 million. The probability of 0. Probability of 2.5 is 0. Clear. So value up to 80.75. So if the total value is 80.75, what is the value of equity? What is the value of equity? 78.25. The total value is 80.75, and you know that the value of the liquid is the combination of debt and what? So if this one is 80.75. And debt is 2.5. The difference is equity. So yeah. Now we have the equity, you have the debt. Can you get the pay? Why is that? Because one, because only to the bar is
0.6.
So bar is 0.6. You have the value of equity? 78.25. Clear. Do you have the value of debt? Is it 2.5? Yeah, just for tax, we divide by 78.25. to 5. The muscle is in a spike of the here, like this one. So base how much? 0.6, 0.61. We are on there. Manzana nahi nahi pa. Manzana nahi pa. 78.25 plus 2.5 times 0.7 equals divide by 78.25, and now the answer multiplied by 0.6. Because I confirmed. Can I find that? RF. Ebanona 8. RF ni 8, ndio. RM ngapi? So RM ni 15. Minus 8. Na bet mepata 0.61. What is the KE?
12.27.
Then finally what? Weight of equity. What is the value of equity? 78.25 divided by 80.75 times KE of 12.27. Plus, we have the weight of debt. The value of debt we have it? 2.5 divided by the total of 80.75 times. We have the pre-tax KD. I say 6. So 6, then you adjust for what? We adjust for tax. So what can we do that? How much? 12.02. y on the panel must start, must switch. Then she'll be in your 5 million. Clear. The champion is 5 million. So that equals 5 million. Can you get the BN? B unit 80 plus 5 times 0.3 minus 8. What is the probability? 0.0125. So times 0.0125. What is that? 81.40. 81.40. It's coming from the cards. Yeah. Right. So therefore, come on, let me find the total is 81.4. Equity to 17? 76.4. So to kona BL, to kona BD. Kona BL, to kona BD. Can you get a B? Now, when you plot after B, because of your company for a debt. The company for a debt doesn't match to me. So, can we get the equity beta? Asset beta is 0.6. Value of equity? 76.4. Value of debt? Is it 5? We are just for tax. Then we divide by 76.4. 76.4. We have the B.
0.627.
So 0.627. So that KE, if we end up RF is 8. Rm is 15 minus 8, and the beta is 0.6, 6 to 7. What is that? 12.389. Can we do 12.39? Decimal place is not bad. Get more. So the weight of equity is 76.4. 76.4 divided by what? 81.4 times KE of 12.39. Yeah. Plus the weight of debt 5 divided by what? 81.4. Do you have the pre-tax KE? Equal to 7.5, then you have to adjust for what? You have to adjust for tax. So you have to adjust for tax. The work is going up. Let's do the last one. The rest is a Malaysia for the policy here. Have to understand the flow. Now the last one. So when debt is 7.5, the value of the firm would be, the value of unlevered is it 80 plus 7.5 times tax minus 8 times, what is the probability? 0.025. What do we have? 82.05. So if the total value is 82.05, value of equity will be what?
74.55.
So BE equal to BA 0.6 times value of equity 74.55 plus value of debt is 7.5.
Yes.
We adjust for tax, we divide by 74.55. So that KE, RF is 8, RN is 15 minus 8, and 0.64. KE equal to 12.48. Now work now. Wakaka is the ngapi? When in that? 74.55. We divide by what? 82.05. Times KE of 12.48 plus the weight of debt 7.5 divided by what? 82.005 times the pre-tax KD in Gapi.
Nine.
I think 9. And 9 lazima to adjust for what? Adjust for tax. So what you could get? Nine one nine two.
Okay,
9.1, 5, 6, 9.2. So 11.92. So can you do for me one? Do for me debt of 10 million. So we are saying that the optimal capital structure, the optimal WACC 11.92. 11.92. But the optimal capital structure, the capital structure is the values of debt and equity. At that level of WACC, our debt is 7.5 million and our equity is 74.55. So it's simply saying optimal capital structure equals debt of shilling 7.5 million. An equity of shilling 74.55 million. As simple as that. If you want to make them weights, you can find the weights. Because it will be 7.5 divided by 82.05. That is for debt. Equity 74.55 divided by 82.05. Yeah. Because I can see they talked about proportions. So proportions, you can use the weights. So optimal capital structure debt, 7.5 divided by 82.05, you get that one. Equity, 74.55 divided by 82.05. So you get 8 marks. But 8 marks is also some good marks. Wait until you reach 42. When 8 marks is standing between you and pass.
Yeah.
So you know how you